Hello and welcome to What the Hey, where I'm your regular host of What the Hey, and today in What the Hey, I am once again answering yet another question. When I go to my notebook of knowledge, I see the question of, what the hey is booba? Now this question was asked by Dre Higby, so hello to you and thank you very much for the question. Now in terms of a very basic description, booba is a television series that has alien-like creatures in random human scenarios. That's about really all I can do in terms of an explanation and a description. Booba is more or less something you just have to experience for yourself, but now it's time for me to give information on it. Funnily enough, the creator for Booba, Ann Wood, is the same creator for the show and franchise of Teletubbies. And if you've seen Teletubbies, Booba is pretty much very close in relation to like what the shows are about. It's actually kind of scary. And then in terms of some other contributions to Booba, the director for Booba is Chris Bernard. So thank you for somehow, in some way, directing Booba. I don't know what your direction for it was, but you did it. The origination for where Booba like comes from is from the UK, which I guess makes sense. Like, we're getting all these weird shows from the UK. We got like Peppa Pig, we got, I don't know, Booba, Teletubbies, like all these weird things are coming from the UK. There's gotta be some like correlation there, I don't know. If you would like to knock out all the material that is provided of Booba, there are two seasons, 104 episodes, and each of those episodes roughly takes about 20 minutes to watch. So it's not like you're watching One Piece where you're just sitting on the couch forever. It's doable, but you may not last for like all of it because it's kind of weird. Also, the people who decided that distributing Booba would be a good idea was Ragdoll Productions, so thank you to you for yet another great contribution to society. Fantastic. April 14th of 2003 is gonna go down in history as a very momentous day because that's the day when Skipping Rope, the first ever episode of Booba, was released. So like, celebrate that day if you want to. Mark that down on your calendar. Sadly, on January 6th of 2006, the episode of Book was the last and current episode of Booba to be released. So wipe a tear. Very sad, I know. So in terms of characters, they do have names in reference to the Boobas. I'll just have pictures, most likely, and then a little text that has their names. They're all very interesting names. I'm glad someone was able to come up with very unique ones. It took a long time, I'm sure, to come up with those names. So the main characters, of course, are the Boobas, but then you also have these random encounters with people, human people, in the show that seemingly seem to be like controlled by the term Booba. And then there's also this random dog that shows up, but it doesn't seem to be controlled by the term Booba. So I don't know what the whole thing with that is, but there's the Boobas, there's the people, and then there's this random dog. I don't know why. Now if you look at the overall reception for Booba, it's pretty good. It's pretty high up there. The reason for that is because Booba is catered and made for kids, which is done really well because they have lights, they have funny sounds, and lots of colors, lots and lots of colors. And it's not like the kids watching the show have to think really hard in their minds like what's going on, because there's hardly any dialogue whatsoever. There's sometimes narration, but that's about it. The most that you'll get is like fart sounds. Booba is also seen as a good thing because the Boobas will do these dances, which essentially make kids want to dance and move around, which, you know, good to get kids doing exercise in a fun way, you know? So like, in that way, it's positive, and I do get that. It's funny to read some of the reviews of Booba because it's like, even as an adult, you'll watch this stuff and it'll be kind of entertaining simply because it just does not make sense. Which goes into my general opinion because I do find it slightly entertaining. I feel like you could take any episode of Booba and like take up the different segments and put them into like a randomly cut just like compilation kind of thing. They also have so many fart sounds. I'm guessing they're fart sounds. I don't really know if that's established to be a thing, but these sound effects in Booba are just so weird. I don't know what's up with it. I also just really adore the fact that there's like grown adults or people who are being paid to go in the Booba suits and like dance around, spin around, do weird things, and just get paid for it. I think that's fantastic. Overall, if you've never seen Booba, maybe spend like 1 or 2 minutes watching an episode. You don't really have to watch the whole thing to figure out that it's kind of weird. But that's essentially the answer to the question, so if you have any questions, let me know and I'll get to answering them as soon as I can. So thank you very much for watching. Bye!